Hi, my name is Katie. I'm a physical therapist at Spalding, specializing in pelvic health. Today I want to talk to you just about pelvic floor anatomy and teach you a little bit about what it is. So the pelvis, here's a model of the pelvis. This is the front. We call this the pubic bone. That's at the very front. In the back is what we call the sacrum. At the bottom of the sacrum, you would find the tailbone, which is not shown here. I'll add that in. And below that, you have a bowl of muscles. We call them the pelvic floor, but very truly, they should be called a pelvic bowl. That is what they look like. So there's two main layers of pelvic floor muscles. Some are deeper in, and I will show you those here. This again is the represents the tailbone. Okay, and you can see it is really like a bowl. If you look from the top, okay, there it is, all right? So here's the tailbone. And this represents the rectum. The second set of muscles are what we call the superficial muscles, meaning they're closer to the surface, the outer surface of the body. And these muscles are more recognizable. This is looking from the bottom. This is for the female pelvis, the vaginal opening. This represents the rectum. And there's a little, kind of a little hole here that represents the urethra, where the urine comes out. These red things here are what we are the muscles. So you can see there's muscles all around. They go across, 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 all around, and right around here. Together, these muscles that are closer to the outside and the muscles that are deeper on the inside is what we call the pelvic floor. The pelvic floor muscles have a lot of work to do. They're really considered a very important part of the core. So when people think about the core, a lot of times they think about the abdominal muscles, okay, the muscles that go along the front and the muscles that go along the back of your back. But the pelvic floor muscles are really the very bottom of the core. So it's important to have good healthy muscles in order for your entire core to work together and for you to be healthy.